Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. Today I will be making some zinc acetate. I will use this to try and make some acetic anhydride via vacuum distillation. If this actually works, I'll post a video on it soon. Producing an acetate salt is quite simple in theory. Just react the metal with acetic acid, boil it down, and you're done. However, as always with chemistry, something unexpected is going to happen inevitably. So to get started, I got myself a piece of zinc metal from some old tire weights I had molten down. This was pretty dirty though, so I decided to remelt it and make some sponge, which is actually going to increase the surface area, therefore making it easier to dissolve later. To do this, I just had to heat it to around 420 degrees Celsius and pour it in some water, trying to leave as much of the slag behind as possible. Now that I have some nice clean zinc metal, I weighed it and it turned out to be around 66.5 grams. It was still somewhat wet though, and since the molar mass of zinc is 65.4 grams, I'll round it up and say I have 1 mole of zinc. So we should also get 1 mole of zinc acetate. In theory, you could just dissolve this in some acetic acid. I get mine from the grocery store and it's around 25%. But this took forever. Even with boiling and some hydrogen peroxide, it didn't look like it was dissolving at all. So I decided to dissolve it in hydrochloric acid first and precipitate as the carbonate. This actually helps to clean it even further. So off camera, I decanted off the acidic acid and put the zinc in a larger beaker with some hydrochloric acid. The acid started to react immediately, and within half an hour all of the zinc was dissolved. I was quite impatient though, so I added way too much HCl, which I will later have to neutralize. If you want to use stoichiometric amounts, it would only need around 100 mL of 32% acid to dissolve it, but I added at least 300. I even poured the solution off into another container before dissolving the last bits with some fresh concentrated acid. While I was doing that, I also prepared a solution of sodium carbonate. I added way too much and barely got it to dissolve with lots of heating. Once all of the metal was gone, I decided to quickly filter the solution through a coffee filter to get rid of any undissolved residues. Afterwards, I started to neutralize it with the solution of sodium carbonate. Make sure to use a large enough beaker, especially if you used such an excess of HCl like I did. Once I reached a pH of about 9, I let the slurry stir under heating for 30 minutes. This will help with the filtration later. Also, any weird globules, where part of the solution is trapped in precipitate, will be able to fully react. Whilst this is happening, the pH might become acidic again, so test it before you're done and add more carbonate if necessary. Now I filtered all of this through a coffee filter. Then I washed it a few times with distilled water to make sure all of the sodium chloride is gone. As a side note, I tested the acetic acid I tried to use at the beginning and there was some zinc in there, so I decided to keep it and use it now to dissolve the zinc carbonate. This was quite straightforward, although it tried to foam up a little, but adding the acid popped all the bubbles anyways. Once the solution is almost clear and the pH is slightly acidic, I filtered it again and now it's just a matter of boiling it down and get some nice crystals. Yeah, that didn't happen. I first tried to precipitate the dihydrate by boiling it down until it reached about 110 degrees, at which point it will start to decompose into the anhydride. On cooling, however, it all turned into some weird syrupy liquid, which just didn't want to grow any crystals, even with lots of scraping the walls and leaving it out overnight. The next day I chose to just get rid of the water and try make the anhydride. So I heated it up again and boiled until it reached about 160 degrees Celsius, at which point it looked like there was no more water vapor coming off. Thinking back, I probably should have gone further to like maybe 200 or just held it at 160 for longer. When I let it cool down, it became syrupy again. At 50 degrees, it was basically like thick honey. Once I came back an hour later, it had all solidified into one huge chunk. This was a pain to get out of the glass evaporating dish. In hindsight, I should have used a metal pan, where I could just smack the back with the hammer to get it all out. Interestingly, this solid was really glass-like, and on the fracture sites you could see the same pattern that normal glass and things like obsidian have when broken. Once I finally got the acetate out, I had to crush the huge chunks with a hammer and then powderize it all with a mortar and pestle. I tried sifting it down to crush the larger pieces again, but I don't recommend doing that, as this powder is really hygroscopic and will quickly become sticky if left out for too long. And that's basically it. The final product weighs about 200 grams, and assuming a yield in the 90% range, it fits well with the molar mass of anhydrous zinc acetate, which is 183.5 grams. Thanks again for watching. I will leave you with a random video of some singlet oxygen creating a nice red glow.